9 pro-Palestine activists have been arrested after blockading Port Melbourne and forcing industrial roads into gridlock. It's done little to deter the demonstrators, who warn there will be more disruptions in coming weeks. Crime reporter Gillian Lanturis.
Peak hour turns to peak frustration.
A lot of yous, honestly. Go get
pro-Palestinian activists refusing to budge, forced off the road by police during the morning rush. On one side, supporters.
From the river to the sea!
Palestine will be free!
On the other, enraged motorists.
I've been stuck for 3 hours, so I'm really pissed off now.
The group blocked Lorimer Street in Port Melbourne around 6 this morning, dumping vehicles outside the Defence Science Technology Group and other businesses they claim are aiding the war across the globe.
We are here to disrupt the sale and trade of military tech that supports genocides.
Australia's decision to back a ceasefire in Gaza hasn't appeased them.
Lives are being lost day by day, and we are the ones making the weapons, giving them the intelligence to do this.
That's no consolation for the hundreds of motorists who were banked up for kilometres.
1 hour and a half, which is no good for the business and is not benefit to anyone.
Is that what you needed this morning?
Not really, no.
The major difficulty police are facing is actually removing these protesters. They've glued themselves to cars and to the road. This protester cemented her arm to the vehicle, taking police an hour to remove her with an angle grinder.
Is that the best way to get your message across?
She was one of 9 protesters arrested and bailed. The group warns there are more surprise disruptions to come.
We will fight like this is a genocide.
Just makes it really hard, and I want to get home to the family.
Gillian Lanturis, 9 News.